Ella Fitzgerald, The Tale of a Vocal Virtuosa by Andrea Davis Pinkney and Brian Pinkney. Track 2, Jammin at Yale. Soon, Ella had audiences eating out of her hand. She went on to win talent showcases all over Harlem. In 1935, the Harlem Opera House signed her as a featured singer. One night, Bardo Ali, the master of ceremonies for the Chick Webb Orchestra, saw Ella perform. That's when Bardo knew that Chick needed Ella and that Ella needed Chick, that the two of them could make beautiful music together. But you see, Chick was a finicky bird, easy to ruffle, hard to please, a perfectionist. He was a jazz drummer who liked his music hot. Swing music was Chick's style, cut the rug rhythms that put the pulse on a party. He believed folks came to hear the instruments in his band, not some singer. Besides, he already had a singer for his orchestra, a guy named Charlie Linton. What Chick didn't know was that Ella's voice was its own instrument. When Bardo took Ella to meet Chick, Chick agreed to give Ella a chance. He told her she could sing with his orchestra at a college dance the next night at Yale University, the Ivy League, where getting loose don't always come easy. Chick told Ella that if she could work that college crowd, she could join the band. So Ella went to Yale with a purpose, and man, once Ella started singing, she had these Yaleys jamming. That night, Chick welcomed Ella into his band. He took her under his wing, and the two of them flew to the Savoy Ballroom, the hippest dance spot in Harlem.